happy. I would like to bring up Jen Joseph, who is a publisher and editor at Manatee Press and who has brought many a queer voice out into the world. So, thank you.
Hi, this is so awesome, and thank you so much for including me. You know, I was trying to come up with something to write, and Elizabeth, being the writing teacher, sent prompts. I was just like, okay, you know. I could write about how my mom took me to see Bobby Kennedy in 68 when I was 7 years old, and I remember it very, very intently. But no, I'm not going to do that. And then I was like, I can talk about when I came to San Francisco in 1979, January of 79. It was like 6 weeks after the Jonestown Massacre and Harvey Milk got shot. And I was 18 years old, and you know, there was like a giant cloud over the city of San Francisco just from those two things. But I'm not going to write about that. And then I was like, I could talk about, you know, how it was like 12 years of conservatism from the time I was 19 until I was 31, you know, and how young people today after 8 years of Barack Obama just don't understand that, you know, we had, my entire 20s was spent just fighting really, really big monsters. Yeah. But I'm not gonna write about that. And then I could talk about, you know, like, and then I got another thing, like, what about the punk thing, you know? You're a man, you could write about how, you know, Janet Weiss's leader Penny, you bought her first drum set from a pawn shop on 6th and Mission. I was like, no, I'm not gonna write about that. And then it was like, oh, you could write about, you know, how Toby Vail crashed into your house when she was 18 and came and saw your band play and then went home and started Bikini Kill and it broke the whole Riot Girl thing. But then I was like, no, I can't write about that either. So I decided to write this instead. Okay, so, and by the way, this is what 56 looks like. That the table in the back is full of a bunch of Manatee books, all the LGBTQI stuff that Manatee published starting in 1994. Those are just free display if you want to order any of them, they're online. Okay, so this is called Being an Ally and the Evolution of Language. Allies, alliances, allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the fags of the United States of America. In 1994, people would have laughed at that line, but not today. It's just not funny because transgressive behavior is no longer in fashion. And hi, Kathy Acker, I'm looking at you right now. Outrageousness back in the day. And today's awareness of microaggressions and intersectionality and the idiotic conversation I had last year with an earnest young man who said I was a colonialist just by standing there behind the Manatee table at that anarchist academic conference. And when I pointed out that I'm descended from refugees who've been on the run for 2,000 years, for crying out loud, and I personally haven't colonized a damn thing except for this here table full of books that contain ideas that might change people's lives for the better, and he wasn't hearing any of it because, you know, patriarchal privilege, and obviously I was being judged by my skin color, and hey, I look like I'm white except Jews weren't even considered white until the 1970s, even then, and weren't allowed into schools or country clubs or neighborhoods to purchase homes, and no Mardi Gras parade for Jews, and the list goes on and still does. Price killer. Sorry, I'm getting off the topic, but not really. Outsiders, persecuted, hated, dismissed, others. There's a personal parallel there, I get it. I grew up with it. I wake up with it every day. You don't celebrate Christmas, but it's an American holiday. Mm-hmm. Allies, alliances, allegiances. I pledge allegiance to the hags of the United States. And there was Bambi Lake telling me just 3 weeks ago how it's sad that the word tranny is no longer acceptable, and that Tranny Shack had to change its name due to the transgender community being offended, and really, it's a generational thing. Time marches on. Just like back in the 80s, So many, many gay men died here in San Francisco, and the government did nothing. And there was fear and grief, but unity and community took care of each other as best they could, and the cheers that went up in August of 98, when the BAR Newsweekly had their first issue in 17 years that had zero obituaries reported for people who died from AIDS. But meanwhile, people in San Francisco are still dying from AIDS, and Justin Chin died just last year from Hep C and AIDS-related causes, and when I mailed Justin Super Fundamentals, Christian Family in Singapore, a copy of Justin's selected works that I had edited and published, his brother sent me an email that Justin's death was not related to AIDS, that the doctors at the hospital did not mention AIDS to him or Justin's mother, and it broke my heart, and it still does every single day, and even now at this moment, because what is true and real just cannot be accepted by some people, and that's why Justin had to find another place to call home, far from where his life began. And we welcomed him with love and poetry, and it always gave me a hard time that his writing wasn't included in the Beyond Definition anthology that Manatee published in 1994, right after we signed a national distribution deal. And it was the first nationally distributed publication that included writing by Michelle T, Allie Leibgott, Simon Shepherd, Marcy Blackman, Trevor Healy, Alvin Orloff, and lots of other writers who went on to do great things. And I'll never forget sitting on the living room floor in North Beach discussing the subtitle with Marcy and Trevor, should it be new writing from gay and lesbian San Francisco or new writing from queer San Francisco? And we went back and forth and back and forth, and we decided to go with the gay and lesbian because older folks rejected the word queer as offensive, so we erred on the side of inclusiveness. And it was gay and lesbian because the initials GLBT, not LGBT, and were in fashion, and QQIA showed up much later, and it's still alive and expanding. It's a generational thing. And in 1996, Bambi Lake's memoir didn't sell at all. I gave her most of her books because America wasn't ready to hear about boys who were girls. It took 20 years and was the first book that documented the Cockettes' history. And Bambi's version of their history pissed off so many of the Cockettes that they got their act together to write and publish their own history. And made an award-winning documentary, and the world's a better place because of it. A very young Bambi appears in one of the film's final shots, which was a sweet acknowledgement of her contribution. In her book, Bambi refers to herself as a transsexual because Kate Borenstein hadn't yet popularized the term transgender in the English lexicon and had yet to explain to America on Phil Donahue's daytime talk show the difference between transgender and transsexual. Well, that is at least according to Bambi. And 2 years ago, the Library of Congress acquired all of Manatee's LGBTQQI titles for special collection. And the Library of Congress invited me to participate on a publishing panel as part of its Pride celebration. And when the moderator asked, what's the future of LGBT publishing? Instant enemies were made when I said, I look forward to the day when there will be no LGBT publishing, when LGBT characters and stories and lives and experiences are totally accepted and valued on par with every other experience woven brightly into the fabric of our society, and pain and fear and animosity and rejection will be replaced with gladness and appreciation and love and acceptance in the artistic equation that adds up to the short time we have on this planet, and fiction will just be fiction regardless of whom the characters choose to love. And people under a certain age gave me the side eye, and finally did not know what to say, because clearly I was messing with their sense of identity. And one of the only people who approached and said anything afterwards was a 75-year-old honoree photographer and publisher, Status Orphanos, who said, yes, it will happen. Not in my lifetime, but maybe in yours, and certainly in your daughter's. It's a generational thing. And my daughter is bi, and the work continues, because rarely has victory been declared without the help of allies and the evolution of language to describe, understand,